I was trying to get digital projectors into the theaters. Bob Zemeckis and Jim Cameron came and said, look, we want to get 3D into the theaters. And now that you've got digital theaters, we can actually do that. Would you join us in showing the theater owners that you can do 3D? And I said, well, that'd be good, because in order to do 3D, you have to have digital theaters. So it would promote my idea of digital theaters. But then when I saw the test that we did, which was about 5 minutes long, of Star Wars in 3D, I realized how great it was and how great it looked.
Oh, my.
Watching a film in 3D, it's hard to explain. It's the difference between watching a film in black and white and a film in color. It works in black and white, but it also works better in color. The depth brings a lot of reality to the digital characters. You just feel that they're more realistic. They actually take up the real space instead of being sort of plastered on the screen in 2D.
How rude.
Also, in terms of depth and telling the story, there's a lot of issues where things are going on in the background that are very important, and you notice them more in 3D than you do in 2D.
There's always a bigger fish.
I believe very strongly with 3D that I don't like the gimmick part of it. I don't like things coming out into the audience. I like everything to be behind the proscenium. I think that's where the real advantage of 3D is. It just makes a much better experience out of it. 3D and conversion of 3D is not a technical thing. It's an art that you need artists for. We had an advantage which most people who try to do conversions don't have, in the fact that the people who've worked on the film, especially in visual effects, Dennis Muren, John Knoll, they were there on the set every day taking measurements, seeing things. So you really, in order to do a good conversion, you have to have somebody that says, no, this person was sitting in front of that person. That person was sitting way back in the background. This was over here. So they can remember and have notes that say where everything is. So by having that extra information and having the skill set of ILM with their experience, their knowledge of what went on the actual set, we were able, I think, to create a really good 3D experience. Star Wars was designed to be on the big screen. This will be the third generation that will be allowed to see it on the big screen. And to me, that's a great plus, because the film was designed as an immersive experience. And I know when you're young, it's just an overwhelmingly powerful event.
We'll handle this.